This is the third spring when psychologist Polina Shadrina and her daughter Sofia spent in Warsaw instead of their native Kyiv. Shadrina, a refugee, helps her daughter with homework.
Where is the beginning of the task and where is the end? Are you sure this is the beginning?
They lived in Kyiv when Russia launched its full-scale invasion of Ukraine. The daughter has autism spectrum disorder, and after a month, Sofia's mental health got worse. So Shadrina says they fled to Warsaw.
She heavily reacted to each air siren, even at night. Then she began to wake up at the slightest noise and had trouble falling asleep. And then she refused to go outside at all.
A child psychologist herself, Shadrina says many children who stayed in Ukraine and many who fled are suffering from mental health issues.
Sure, some children adapt faster, but there are those whose anxiety has increased to such an extent that it affects sleep and appetite. In addition, there are adults around who are also tense.
Another psychologist, Katerina Timakina, works for Veteran Hub, an NGO network that supports veterans and their relatives.
This amount of stress is not something you could have been prepared for. Anxiety disorders increased by 48%, depressive episodes and adjustment disorders increased by 46%.
Counseling and therapy centers like this one called Open Doors also confirm a jump in the number of appeals for help.
Both military and civilian appeals increased by 80%. We currently have 30 specialists working in the center, and every week we receive about 30 new applications.
Others suffer from post-traumatic stress disorder, or PTSD. The Ukrainian Ministry of Health reports that in 2023, that number of patients with PTSD quadrupled since 2021.
Among the symptoms may be insomnia, aggression, and flashbacks, when a person seems to return to the moment of trauma and doesn't understand what is happening around him.
Katerina Timakina says it will take time to know the real scale of the war's impact on mental health, because Ukrainian civilians and military personnel are still experiencing the trauma.
We will fully understand the mental impact on us as a society only when the hostilities are over. Separately talking about the military, their mental health state can be evaluated 6 months to a year after the first wave of demobilization.
The World Health Organization says 1 in 5 people living in conflict areas around the world has some form of mental health condition. Applying the UN estimate to the Ukrainian population in 2024 means about 8.5 million people are likely affected. Alicia Bakalets, VOA News. Kyiv.